Do I think that the majority of the people watching this video right now should be in a relationship? Honestly, no, I don't. How's it going, guys? My name's Cole Hastings. If you're new to the channel, it's all about vegan fitness and self-help, so consider subscribing and hitting the bell so you don't miss a video. You know, I've wanted to make this video for a long time now. I just didn't know the right time to do it, but I feel like now's a good time as any time. And it's been about half a year now, which is crazy to think. Since I've been in a relationship, I've definitely learned a lot in this half a year. I've definitely learned a lot from my previous relationship as well. I have been in two serious relationships so far. Both of them lasted about 3 years, and in both of them, I was the one who got dumped. And this video is not a way for me to get back at my significant others. Everything I'm going to explain are the things that I did wrong. All of the things I'm going to go over are what I've learned about myself and what I could have done differently. So I'm taking responsibility for, you know, them dumping me. I don't think that they were wrong in their choices, and I want to make this video to make sure that people who are young watching, who don't have the same knowledge that I've acquired from being in two long relationships, they don't make the same mistakes that I did in my relationships, and they avoid being in a relationship until they have all of the things that I'm going to go over in this video. So first off, I want to talk about things you need to do for yourself before getting into a relationship and the type of person that you should also be looking for. So before you get into a relationship, this is the biggest thing. The biggest thing to make a relationship work is you first must love yourself. You first must be happy in your own skin, confident with yourself, or the relationship is not going to work. The saying that you can't love someone else until you love yourself is absolutely true. I've experienced this firsthand. My first relationship, I was in the midst of loving myself. I wasn't fully confident with myself, and I didn't really have anything going for me during that time in the first relationship. So I didn't really have much to be confident about, and I'm gonna go over how you can have things to be confident about later in the video. So if you have those things about yourself that you're still insecure about, those are really gonna get brought to the surface in your relationship. When this person brings that thing up without them even intentionally doing it, or maybe they do intentionally do it, if they disagree with you on it, or if they critique you about it, it's gonna cause a lot of problems in your relationship. You need to have a strong foundation of confidence before you even consider being in a relationship, and lots of love for yourself if you want the relationship to work. It's as simple as that. The problem is, the reason that so many people pursue relationships is to fill that hole within themselves that they don't like about themselves. And no person is going to make that hole filled. You need to fill it yourself. You need to become confident with yourself. A person that you're in a relationship with can make you feel better about yourself, but those things, those deeply seated beliefs that you hate about yourself, or these things that you're just really insecure about, are never going to get fixed unless you fix them yourself first. And if you do not do this, you're going to keep wondering why your relationships don't last. This next one is more geared towards men, but I guess this could apply to some women as well. Men, you need to have a strong purpose, a strong reason for living outside of the relationship in your life before you decide to pursue one. If you want to casually date someone and not be in like a long-term relationship, you know it's probably going to end one day and it's just like nice to be with that person, that's totally fine. But if you are dedicated on finding someone you want to spend the rest of your life with, or at least be with them for a long, long time, the only way that that is going to work, the only way that they are truly going to love you, is if you have some sort of purpose you are driving towards every single day in your life, your passion. That needs to be your primary focus in life as a man, above everything else. A lot of women will tell you that they want themselves to be the primary focus of your life, that they want all of your attention to be on them, but this is just not true. Try to do this. Try to not have a purpose and try to put all of your attention on them, and see what happens, because it's not gonna work out in the end. As a man, your purpose in life always comes first above your relationship. This is not a selfish thing. This is genuinely what the significant other wants, whether they tell you it or not. Now, this might mean you don't see your significant other every single day, or you don't spend as much time with them a week, which will be totally fine, as long as when you're with them, you're putting your full time and attention on them. This was a huge problem with me. I had a purpose and a passion that I developed during my second relationship, but when I was with this girl, most of the time I was just working on my laptop, working on my purpose, and putting pretty much zero attention into the relationship, which is a huge problem. I think that if I would have spent less time during the week with her and spent those days that I would have been with her working, just working by myself, then I think that things would have gone a lot smoother. So if you don't see your significant other as much because you have that purpose, it's actually going to make them more attracted to you, believe it or not. And if you hang out with them like once a week still, twice a week still, and during those times you're just putting your full effort and attention on them, which they absolutely deserve, and that's absolutely how it should be, then the relationship is going to work a lot smoother. My problem was that I was focused more on the quantity, the times in the week that I would see here, the amount of times in the week that I would see here, over the quality. In my first relationship, this was like happening during high school as well. So I mean, I was still young, which is a big part of it, but I didn't have any purpose at all. I also had a tough time holding a job. I've always had a tough time holding jobs, stable jobs that I really, really dislike. I've always been someone who enjoys working for themselves, who enjoys making their own hours, and I work harder when I work for myself. But yeah, a big thing with my first relationship was that she always saw that, you know, I could never keep an actual job, and I didn't have a job by the time that we broke up. Because I was in college, that was a huge thing, but to her, that was a big problem. And I'm sure that that made her lose a lot of attraction for me because I didn't really have any purpose, any drive, or anywhere I was going in life. Before you even think about getting in a relationship, at least as a man, you need to find your purpose. You need to have something stable going for you. Otherwise, the relationship is really, really gonna suffer. And the woman, she might be really attracted to you at the start, but once she realizes that you have no purpose, no passion in life, and that you're kind of staying complacent and you don't care about growing as a person every single day, they're gonna start to lose attraction to you over time. The next thing to remember, this goes for both men and women, is to not put your significant other on a pedestal. Now, before you criticize me, I'm not saying that you shouldn't put your time and attention and effort into your significant other when you're with them, or maybe even when you're not with them, and do very nice things for them all the time, do the little things for them. That's amazing, and that's how a relationship should be, and giving them all your love, that's how it should be. But if you start to become too attached to them, if you start to wonder where they are on a daily basis and you're thinking about them 24/7, that shows that you have nothing else going for you in your life. And they'll feel that energy, whether you think it or not. The energy you give off in the universe is very real, and they're gonna feel that you are obsessing over them, basically, and that's gonna make them lose attraction towards you. So no, I'm not saying treat your significant other poorly. I'm just saying don't obsess over them and put them as your main thing in life. Always put yourself first, especially as a dude. Like, just think about this. I bet the person that you're most attracted to right now, the person that you want the most, is the person that rarely texts you, the person that you rarely get to see. We love this mystery and scarcity. It makes someone else, whether you're a male or a female, so much more attractive. You just need to have a good balance of it when you're actually in a relationship, because if you never see your significant other, then it's like you're not in a relationship, and it is like you truly don't care about them. And I think a huge problem with my second relationship was that I stopped putting myself first towards the end of the relationship. Something shifted in me. I was super confident in myself. I was super happy with myself at the start of the relationship, and I'm sure that made her so attracted to me that she wanted to go out with me. But towards the end of it, the last few months of that relationship, I became less confident. I became more insecure. I became less confident in her and what she was doing when she wasn't with me, and I was like starting to be more needy. She started working more during this time, and I was like, I'm worried that I'm not gonna see you as much anymore. And she's like, well, I don't know what you want me to say. Like, that's the way it is. And it made me seem like I was focusing less on my purpose in life and more on seeing her, and that showed, and I'm sure that that was a big part of it. You just need to let go. You need to have trust, and I'm gonna go over trust in a little bit here. But trust me, if you become too attached, if you obsess over the relationship too much, they're gonna feel that energy, and they're gonna become less attracted to you. And there's this really good quote, I don't know if it's always true, but from my personal experience, this has shown to be true. And the quote says, "The one who cares least in the relationship has the most power. And now let's go over the next thing that I really want to talk about, which is, again, one of the most important things in every relationship. It is communication. You must be completely transparent with your significant other about how it makes you feel when they do something or the relationship is not gonna work. Any problem, or if you didn't like something they did, you need to tell them. Now, if they do this or if you do this and they get defensive or you get really defensive and you think you are always the right person in this situation, that's revealing an insecurity about you, and that's revealing the type of person that isn't willing to change and isn't willing to grow in a relationship to make it work. And you need to listen to what they have to say and take it in fully. A lot of the times, my significant others would tell me things they don't like about me or things that were truly bad about me, toxic things about me that I needed to change about myself and that I wanted to change about myself. And I'd be like, okay, you're right. This is something that I want to change, and I'm glad that you pointed it out. That's the great part about relationships, is you can get this objective view about yourself, or at least pretty much objective, a nice outside perspective of the toxic traits of yourself. And when they told me these things, I'd be like, you're right, I need to change this, I'm going to make the steps to change this, and then I'd actually just do nothing. If you need to write down what they said to remember to do these changes that they want you to do, that are changes that would make you a better person, then do that. Just make sure you are truly listening to what they have to say. And speaking of change, that leads me to my next point, which is the willingness to grow together. I think the primary purpose of a relationship in life is to grow as a person with this person, to have mutual benefits with this person. It shouldn't be for some lust-filled reason where you're just super attracted to this person and you'll be able to have sex with them pretty much whenever you want. It shouldn't be for a reason to feel validated as a human being, which, like I said, is a huge reason that people get into relationships, is to feel validated, to feel better about themselves. It should be about wanting to grow together. And that's another huge reason why I think that these relationships did not work out in the end, is just because I was not compatible with these women. No matter how many mistakes I made, I just don't think we had the same goals. I don't think we connected truly on a deeper level as much as I wanted to. And I think that that was also part of the reason why this was never going to work out forever in the first place. And for anyone struggling with a breakup right now, which a lot of you might be if you're watching this video, I just want to tell you that the breakup means that you are one step closer to finding that person, to finding that significant other that is truly meant for you. Changing yourself completely for a person is a huge problem, and people do this and they stay in those toxic relationships that make the other person change you so much, change your core beliefs, change who you are as a person, just so you can keep that person, just so you can keep that validation in your life. And this is a big, big problem. To be honest, this never really happened to me. Both of my relationships, each woman did not really force me to ever be someone I wasn't, which was great, but I've seen this a lot with other relationships. So you need to be aware of the difference between changing toxic traits about yourself, stuff that really does need changing and would make you grow as a person and make you a better person, and things that you don't need to change about yourself, that you just like about yourself. Like if you're a gamer, if you're a nerd, if you're into anime and they're like, I don't like how you're into anime. Luckily, this didn't really happen in either of my relationships, but if it did, I'd be like, whoa. If you don't fuck with anime, that's okay, but I'm gonna always fuck with anime. And that's really the reason why I would be in a relationship again if I am to get into a really serious long-term relationship again, is to grow with this person, to become a better person through having another person who is so much like me in my life. Now I want to talk about trust. Trust is so goddamn important in a relationship, and it's something that I've struggled with in every relationship that I have been in. Now, I have developed some seriously bad trust issues over time for reasons I'm not going to go over in this video. They're pretty personal issues, but yeah, those seriously destroyed probably both my relationships, more so the second relationship. I remember a lot in my second relationship, I would always need to know where she was. I would be constantly asking her who she's talking to. I would like look over at her phone. You know, I wouldn't go so far as to try to see her phone and try to, you know, dive into her phone and be like, all right, let's go through everything. but it was still a huge toxic problem. I was like checking her location too. Like, these are things that just show that you don't trust the person. And many of you watching this will believe this, many of you watching this won't, but the more you believe that your significant other isn't a trustworthy person, the more that they're not going to be a trustworthy person, if that makes sense. You know, you attract what you think. We know this now a lot from my previous videos. And the more you start seriously believing that this person is not trustworthy, that this person is doing things behind their back, the more likely they are going to do things behind your back, as crazy as that sounds. It seems so paradoxical, but the less you care about what the other person is doing, the more likely they're not gonna do something bad to you or do something untrustworthy or unfaithful to you. But what I've learned is that you just need to blindly trust this person. You need to trust that this is the person that you thought they were when you first got into the relationship with them, the person that you thought that they would not be unfaithful, that you know that they're a very trustworthy person, and unless they give you a reason for you to think that they're not trustworthy, unless they do that, then there's no reason for you to be thinking that way. So if you still have trust issues, like I still kind of do, I'm sure I probably do, even though I haven't really experienced them in a while because I haven't been in a relationship, then I seriously advise against getting in a relationship. You need to figure yourself out first, love yourself first, have a purpose first, before you even consider being in a relationship. All of those things need to be ticked off. You need to have your life together. Your life isn't going to magically get together better if you decide to get into a relationship. So if you enjoyed it, leave a like on it. It helps push this out to more people. It'll help grow my channel, which has been growing a lot lately. Thank you guys so much for watching my videos, for sticking around to the end, for engaging. It really has just changed my life, all of this stuff. And yeah, I'm having a good time. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you all in the next video.